Hey everybody, my name is Shay Dempsey. I'm the Global Art Director for Sebastian Professional. I'm a salon owner. I'm without Gerard here today, but we do have Randy at the back of the phone. So we want to try and make this as interactive as possible. So please reach out, ask questions. Hopefully we'll be able to sort of just bounce off one another. So before we get started, just let me take you through the haircut. We're going to bring you through an asymmetric shape, slightly asymmetric shape, by using a wrap cutting technique. And basically it's a Sebastian technique that we developed on how you can over direct hair onto the head shape so that you can bring down that shape to whatever length you want. So if you desire to be longer, the wrapping technique is brought down further to bring it over to the other side. So this is not finished in any way. We still have to do the detail, but what I wanted to try and do today was to actually take you through the steps of the actual haircut itself and how you can make this haircut your own by using the blade and the scissor or a blending shears, or even use scissor and blade, whatever you want. So as you can see right here, we have taken an undercut on the back section, which really brings it just to the middle of the ear. So it's basically, you can either take that away using a clipper, or you can use a scissor or a blending shear to soften it out. You don't even have to have it that short, but that's just me. I like to go a little bit extreme.
You're getting so many hellos from all over the world.
Hello, everybody.
Susie from the UK.
Hi, Susie.
Andrew Dunn says, hey, brother.
Hey, Andrew.
Patricia says, hello. Amruta Singh is giving you the thumbs up. Andrew said that he put you on Wella Global.
Wella Global. Good man, Andrew.
And Gianni saying hello from Switzerland.
Hi, Gianni. So thank you, everybody, for saying hello. That's great. We're off and running. So basically, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you by using a brand new blade. That's the first thing. We're using a brand new blade, and I have a reference point that I want to use on the blade, and that's just at the top of the ear. Small sections, as you can see, and then I'm just tapping that blade. So I still have quite a cut finish, as you can see. See how sharp that blade is, okay? The reason I sort of use a fresh blade is that I want to really have a clean line. I don't necessarily want to over-direct the hair and really diffuse it too much. So elevation is low, and I'm bringing everything, you see how small that section is, and I'm just tapping the blade. So everything is coming and being cut in its natural fall. I did use dark oil as my prep. I don't know what people use when they're prepping hair, when they're using a blade. You can use a leave-in conditioner. You can use something like Potion 9. You can use something like Potion 9 Light if you want. What I'm going to stress about this haircut, because it's asymmetric, is that, guys, small sections. Randy, do you use big sections when you use a scissor?
Depends on how far behind I'm running.
Okay, there you go. So I usually try and keep my sections quite clean, and I try and keep them quite small. The blade is an amazing tool, but it's not a wizard, okay? So if you look at the sections, they're transparent. You can actually see the line underneath. So by taking smaller sections, you're in control. You can then lose that hair, so you have enough hair just in the blade. I can see my line underneath, and I just tap that.
How important is tension?
Well, with this type of a haircut, the tension is quite important, that when you actually hold the hair in the leading hand, that the tension keeps the stress on the hair so the blade will cut the hair properly.
Okay.
If you want to have a looser, if you want to have a looser control, well then, you will have a looser effect. So maybe you're elongating that stroke. But really what you want to try and do is keep the tension strong enough so that the blade will run through the hair.
Dennis is asking, do you ever put the blade underneath?
You can, Dennis. Yes, you can. But it's not something that I do that often. Sometimes if I want to create an accent point, Dennis, so like sometimes if you want to make the top piece stick up a little bit, you could maybe go underneath and the shorter bits will hold the longer bits up. So it's a good question, but it just depends on how or what you want to work on. So if you can see, guys, now I'm lifting my hand off the head a little. So I'm now coming off the head a little. So it's almost like graduation. Now I can still see my line, and I just start to cut, feel the line, lifting it off. And you'll see when everything is coming in the natural fall, the horizontal line is the blade. And this is something that will keep that asymmetry going. Now, let me just comb the hair. Can you see that, Randy? Mm-hmm. So you now start to see that graduation.
It's beautiful.
Yeah? Mm-hmm. So we're not getting a solid line, we're getting a graduated line. So we're rounding. And by just taking the hair and lifting it out off the head, you're gonna soften that line because the blade is gonna help you do that. I don't know if you've noticed as well that as I start to rise above the head, I'm actually elongating the stroke. So the stroke is now being elongated a little bit more, just dropping the head down a little bit. So let me explain that. So I'm just taking my next section, nice and small, bringing it out off the head. Now, I tapped it short, tap, 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 to create the line. Now watch my stroke. So it's a little bit more elongated. So what's that doing? That's basically reducing the weight and the length at the same time. So it's basically giving you graduation. So pulling it out, and I'm just gently elongating that stroke.
So the longer the stroke, the softer the ends?
Exactly. The shorter the stroke, the more solid the line. Now, as you can imagine, everything is coming to me. So if you're trying to find out like how and what's that line that I'm trying to create from the elevation, I think of it trying to come out to my chest. Mm. So I'm just basically coming from here out to my chest. So then I can follow the line underneath because I see it, and I come out to my chest. So everything is just being brought. And if you look at my body position, it's not really moving anywhere. It's just sort of staying here. So my next section.
Vidaya is asking, I'm sorry if I have your name pronounced wrong, asking what you would call this cut.
So it's an asymmetric shape. So okay. Basically it's an asymmetric, almost like a little asymmetric crop or something like that. I mean, it's just basically showing off how the shape can sort of go from shorter to longer without it looking too disconnected. I hope that, hopefully you're gonna hang on, mm-hmm. And you will see basically the
you're moving
end.
At a good pace, so.
Yeah, we're moving at a good pace.
Getting there.
So you can see, again, just nicely just going through the hair. See like that, we're not tearing the hair. There's nothing aggressive here. It's really, really soft now.
What do you have in the hair? Because it looks moist.
Yeah, so again, I did a bit of a double up there. It's there, it's dark oil and Potion 9 Light. And I because these are blonde doll heads, I do put quite a lot in because they've been bleached and pressed and God only knows what's happened to these poor doll heads. But you have to be aware that you're using a blade. So by using a blade in the right way, you'll be fine. So again, just working everything around horizontal with the blade and we're good to go. So we're moving along nicely. Don't be afraid if the hair starts to get a little dry and you feel a little bit of tension, irregular tension coming onto the hair. Don't be afraid to dampen the hair back down again. And I can't stress enough, like, the blade can only hold so much hair. So like, even that there is a little too much. Mm. So just remember, take it away. Take it away, because by using the blade in the right way, it becomes your friend. It becomes your enemy if there's too much in there. Mm. There's your little guide. Pull it out, start. And you know, you can't hear any noise. Mm. You can't hear any aggressive sounds. So like, I really like to keep control. Small sections are your best friend here. And for your client who's gonna be in the chair, it's a nice experience. It's a very artistic experience. It's not an experience where it's like, oh, what's this? Oh, this feels a little strange. So I'm just giving you tips of like what I do when I'm cutting hair in the salon. Any more questions, please don't hesitate. Randy is here for you. I'm willing to hopefully be able to talk and cut at the same time, and let's make it as interactive as possible. So
you're getting a lot of comments. There's just a lot of people saying, you know, they love it and really loving what you do.
Great, that's fantastic. So
someone actually called you the master.
Oh wow, that's great. Well, hopefully the master is going to be able to get this right. So let me just show you before we start to wrap the hair, okay? So let's really have a look at this little shape.
That's looking nice.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm. Sherry's asking, do you suggest changing the blade after every cut?
Well, Sherry, to be honest, I do. I mean, and you never really know what type of hair you're going to be dealing with. So I just say, what's the point in hanging on and then it being a bad experience for the clients or, you know, damaging the hair. Just buy yourself some fresh packs of blades on Hairbrained and basically you're away. So the only time now we're going to change our body position is to help us with the next section. So you can see the center parting here. So now we got to go and we got to go small. So we're going to, from this side, small sections, just like the other side, small sections, stay in control all the time. And now we're going to lay that over on top of the previous section. So now we're moving into the other side. And this is what we call a wrap cutting technique.
Shay, I think it might be helpful to just give a quick look of the finished, or the almost finished basic shape.
Yeah. So basically you can see we went shorter, down, and you can actually see the symmetry of where it's coming down.
Oh, cool.
Okay, so by wrapping the hair over, you're going to cut internally, take some of the weight out, but you're also going to increase with the length. So that's what wrap cutting does. It's almost like over-directing, but it's also taking the weight and the length at the same time. It's a really clever
super
idea,
efficient, yeah.
And it's super efficient. It's super fun for the salon. And you can make it as long and as short as you want. So again, now we're starting to wrap the hair. So again, just start to use it in its natural flow. Come through.
How careful do you have to be that this is going over the top of the head and not around the front?
Very
forehead?
Good. Okay. So, great question. So basically, when I look at natural fall, you always have to think of it like there's that natural fall of it lying down.
Mm-hmm.
So remember, if you want to leave it longer in this section, you have to wrap to the natural fall.
Mm-hmm.
You don't over-direct it back. You basically take it, and now your blade is going to be working horizontally. So it's going to be working flat. Make sure that you have enough hair or not enough hair, maybe for more control. There's your line. And you start to skim to that line. So basically, that horizontal line will give you more length coming down. So that's important. That was a good question, Randy. So it's just basically taking everything and mirroring what you've just done before. Small sections. Now you can see the skim. I can see the line underneath. And I'm sitting it down. So yes, as I said, why wrap cutting? Wrap cutting does two things. It's going to reduce the weight on that side so that basically by taking that weight away and that length, you can see it's going to reduce it enough so that it almost just blends in.
It's nice.
And that's a lot of hair. A lot of hair coming over there. So the same thing, my body position, I'm still standing here. Haven't gone anywhere. And it's sort of nice as well that you're not sort of leaning over and you're not pushing yourself and you're not, so the horizontal stays horizontal. Everything just stays and you're just bringing it around, horizontal, hit. The only time, as I said, you're gonna have to change is when you want your sections, because I don't trust myself to get a nice clean section on the other side. So you just drop it down, take your next section, and run down the head, and flip it over. Everybody get what I'm doing here? Do they think it's a crazy idea or is it all good?
No, everybody's loving it.
Okay, good.
Tagging friends and
good. So again, I'm just keeping everything as clean as possible. So just popping that there, isolate that. Maybe we need to use a little bit more water. And what I really love about this shape, and you're gonna see this happen, is that like if you were doing it for a client who really likes to change their hair as well, and they want to flip it to this side, you've got the asymmetric shape, but then if you really want to create it super strong, you can bring it all over to one side.
Mm.
And you could do a different color maybe. You know, you could change the color. So again, I'm just staying out to my chest. I can see my line underneath, and it's just, bang. Next section, nice and small. See how flat?
Orlan is asking, she loves the wrap cutting on short hair, but what if you do it on long hair?
Well, on long hair, you know, again, it's wrap cutting was something that was designed primarily at the start was for long hair, and where you would actually sort of wrap the hair from one side to the other, have a reference point, and basically what you can do is you can do shorter layers. So you would take one piece shorter, the next piece longer.
Mm.
Wrap around, so you would flip.
Mm.
And it worked really, really well. It was actually, I used it in one of the collections that we did for Sebastian. And anybody that knows Sebastian will remember that it's a great sort of technique to be used on all different types of lengths. It's just getting your head around what it does.
Savat is asking, can this technique you're doing be done on curly hair?
Well, it could be, but I don't recommend the blade on curly hair. So you could still wrap the hair, of course, absolutely, but you have to look at it in the sense of like, is it the right thing to do? Is wrap cutting the right thing? What do I want to create with the curls? Do I want to create something that's asymmetric? Do I want to create something that's going to reduce the weight? But
it's really pretty.
Yeah, we get where we're going here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. So we're moving along nice and quick. And as I said, this could be something that you use in the salon, and it's fast, you know? So this is almost like, you know those crazy drag overs? Not so much anymore. We don't see so many drag overs anymore, but you want to try and keep everything really, really clean and really, really flat to the head. Because remember, you're following a line. You know, with Sebastian, we try and explain what we do. They also have to follow a line or a reference point or some part of a line that is going to give you the balance.
Shay, we've had a couple of requests that when you get to the back, they want to see you cut the back. So maybe halfway through, we'll spin her around.
Absolutely, no problem. So let's take the section. Now you can really see I'm spending the time on wrapping that hair down, okay? I'm staying in the same position. There's the line. You can probably see it now at this stage. It's starting to appear. And then I just make sure that that's nice and clean. And there it is. Next section. Remember, natural fall. Don't over-direct anything. Just keep it clean, nice and controlled. You can see I've got a small section of hair. Follow, there's the line. There's that guide. And then you can just take that away. Now I'm gonna start.
I'll go
to
over
turn.
Your other shoulder. We'll just put her head toward the back.
And just why don't I turn a little bit this way?
Mm-hmm.
Is that better?
That's great, yeah.
So again, I'm just looking at my wrap.
And how do you handle calyx with this? Albert is asking.
Yeah, calyx would be something that would be in the front, so maybe the weight has to lay over the cowlick.
Mm-hmm.
So be, you know, always, I always incline to do that. So if I'm gonna sort of work with a cowlick, you know, well, it needs that weight to hold it down.
Mm-hmm.
So don't be afraid to just push that weight onto that side. But that's a good question. Cowlicks, we just don't like cowlicks, do we? So again, I'm pulling everything. keep that horizontal line. There's the guide. Everybody okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna come over your, for the last section, come over your other shoulder.
Yeah. I'm coming down. And you can see that I'm controlling everything by just using small sections. I don't wanna go in and just be out of control. So I'm just coming around, wrapping. There's my guide. And then I just take it from that line that I've worked on and I sort of bring the blade down. You see the way I bring the blade down?
Mm-hmm.
And now the next section.
I presume that you have a technique for crossing across the other direction in the back.
Yes, yep. Exactly. There's my guide. There it is. And then I just run it down.
Super cool.
Okay, so now if I just do this for you, you should see, let's go into its natural fall.
Mm-hmm. Nice, thank you.
So you get this really nice little fitted shape.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just fitting and hugging the shape. It's no big wedge, it's not a step. We don't want to do that because we would use, you know, we don't just use blades all the time. We would use a scissor if we wanted to create something that was more geometric. So the reason we are sort of using a blade is because we wanted to fuse that line. So we're coming into the last few sections and really start now to comb it over. And a little bit more moisture. Again, moisture is your best friend for control. You know, when things start to get a little frizzy or things start to get a little bit out of control, it's very hard to actually, you know, contain the hair in the comb. And so again, you can see I'm really keeping my tension on bringing everything over, and there, as you can see now, you can really see that line. So now we can just gently, starts all get a little easier now, just keeping everything in control.
And you don't have to worry about recutting your guide because it's on the underneath and it's also on the outside of your hand, right?
Exactly. It, you know, it's so easy to follow now because you've built that. So it's just a case of just working it along. The most important is that you're keeping control and you're only cutting the top.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people go in too deep and then they recut everything. You're laying that onto that section. So remember that, like you're laying the hair onto the previous section. And that's why I can't stress enough is that, I'm here that I'm actually able to see that line underneath, see it? Like, it's literally so obvious. Now, can you imagine if you'd taken a lot of hair? There's just no possible way that you would have control or you would have the balance or just the actual shape of blending it in. There's too much hair in your hand.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really important that when you're thinking about what you're doing is set yourself up for...
Saval said she's gonna... I can't tell if that's a man or a woman, but... said, I'm going to do this technique to a client of mine tomorrow. Thank you for your time, sir.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
And post it on Sebastian page.
There you go. And Gypsy said, do you ever use the plie razor? I keep cutting myself and think I should use the stick razor instead, but I'm stubborn.
So the plie razor is the open blade.
Mm.
And I have had this with Gerard that I never really used it in the right way. So Gerard's going to teach me. We're going to have a session where he's going to actually teach me how to use the open blade the right way, the correct way. I watch him on Hairbrain Live all the time. I think he's a master of how he flicks it and hides it in here behind his hand. I don't have that confidence. So we're going to have a blade off at some stage where he likes to look at me use the feather blade and I really like to look at him using the plie blade. So I think that's something that I'm looking forward to. But to answer your question would be, use something that you don't feel is gonna cut you or something that you're gonna feel super comfortable with. Like, I know if I do that, I'm not gonna cut myself.
Mm.
And I use the blade in many different ways. So I just want to be comfortable that I'm not going to sort of do any damage to myself or maybe to the hair if I catch it too quick. I feel in control with this blade. So again, I'm just wrapping the hair right down, natural fall, wrapping it around. And I'm just coming, I've probably got one or two more sections,
Let's rotate her around.
Yep.
For the last section.
And we're just going to come in here and just wrap. Make sure you've got all that nice tension. You've only got little pieces now, so it's easy. You just tap it with the blade. Wrap it around. Again, this takes a little bit of time to get used to the tension in your hand. Mm-hmm. So when I say to you, take your time, you take the small sections. That's what's going to really help you. By taking small sections is really, really going to make life so much better for you. So if you're losing your line and you don't feel confident with the haircut, like I can't remember the girl who's going to do this haircut tomorrow. If that's going to happen and you do it tomorrow, please, please, please take your time and make sure that you are following a line. The minute you start to lose your way, you know the section's too big. So I can stand here now. So this is our final section. And I'm just going to dampen everything down. And maybe I'll turn so you can really see this final piece here. So you can see now we've got to go from here and really bring the hair all around. Now, take the time to really use your hands, almost like you were dressing the hair. There we go. And really take your time to swish it over. It's a proper swish. And then when it's comfortable and you feel that you've got it, there you go. So elongate that stroke a little.
So every hair matters, put it in its right
place. Every hair matters, exactly. Because you remember, if you've gone forward a little too much and you've taken that off and you're here, what's going to happen? It's going to be shorter. Mm. So it's really important when
you're... So if you really want that corner, you have to really mind where you're over-directing this.
Exactly. I love the way, Randy, because you're a hairdresser, you totally understand this. It's great. Because that corner, if that corner goes, you've lost the asymmetry. You've lost the sort of edginess to it. Now all of a sudden it becomes like a weird page boy. Mm. Or something like that. So let me just turn around. So yeah, you're so right. If you lose that corner, you are really, really in trouble. You know, it's just not gonna have that same edge.
You're getting compliments.
No, great. Great. Well, it's not over yet because we still have a lot to do. Mm. But let me just show everybody. And what I like to see is that it actually fits in to the shape. Like it actually has a cool little shape. So you could actually see that, you know, you've got this really cool little disconnection. It also fits into the head like that. So when you move it and you give it a little shake, it has a line, but it's not like indented in there, you know, it's not something that's so aggressive. So let's move it around. You can start to see here. Now you're going to say, well, what's going to happen? What's going to happen here? But like, this looks cool like that even. Now, let's drop it down.
So now you have decisions to make, right?
So now I always look at it and I go, how did I cut the hair? So it was a natural fall. So when you've combed the hair, remember, that's what you need to do. To make the next step in your head is that you now need to comb the hair, maybe step back from the head, or step back and look at the client, and look at it and go, okay, so what's the natural fall? So now, you have the decision on, this is all layered. All this has been layered, because it's been brought over. So you can see it's not so bulky there. So that weight has gone out of there. Do you really want to sort of go extreme with the disconnection? You know, like this is now up to you. Like, so where do I take it from here? So always remember, take it from where you started. That's your reference point. So I said to you the top of the ear. So basically by bringing it round, now you have that shape of where you want to go. So I wouldn't start here. Why would I start there when I have something to follow my guide? And again, this is all just about how I do it. You could start there if you want, but you're in limbo. You've nowhere to follow. So we're now combing the hair in its natural form. Okay? So there it is. So if I wanted to just take that off, well, then you're going to go here and you're going to have that strong asymmetry. I don't necessarily want to go that strong. So if I just turn the doll head around just like that, the section is going to be the same. It's going to follow and mimic what I'm going to cut the hair. I always do that. I mimic sections. Like if it's a teardrop, it's because I'm going to cut the hair around the head. Now I'm going to take my section and just go to the top of the ear. I'm feeling the ear, and there's the top of the ear like that.
Gypsy said she's gonna teach this to her husband.
Yeah?
Gypsy said, I love the softer look of this razor. Yeah. More lived in, nice work. Zan said she's teaching her husband this cut to do.
Okay, that'll be good.
And Jaffe says, this is awesome.
Oh, fantastic. Thanks so much. So now, look at that. Mm. I mean, if you really wanted to go that extreme, you can go that extreme. So in my personal head, so what I have is, my reference point was just to the top of the ear. I then started to work it for longer, but I would like probably just to go to the earlobe. That gives me enough of an asymmetric look without it being something that's, I suppose, too overdone. You know, I don't like to do anything that's too overdone. So basically, I'm thinking in my head, follow the line. So basically, I have everything here, and I can just follow that line using the blade, and I can just go to the tip of the nose, and I just gently work that blade down.
What advice? I know, like, trimming little bits is always a question. Like, well, how do you trim this in, you know, like, say 6 weeks from now?
Yeah.
And I noticed you're cutting just a little bit off to start with and getting longer. What makes that easier?
Well, basically what it's doing is it's giving you a comfort blanket. So I'm talking about getting to there. Mm-hmm. So in my head, in my reference point, if I do that with my nose and I put that onto my nose, I know I'm somewhere here. Mm-hmm. So the first thing I want to try and do is go gentle. So even on this, because I, you know, I'm going gentle. So I use the heel of the blade and I just go gently down. So basically I'm working from the tip of the nose and hopefully I'm going to get somewhere where I desire. So less is more sometimes.
Huge compliment here coming from Greg. He says, Shay Dempsey, you're my idol with your creativity. I'll meet you in person one day and I hope I'll be able to work with you. Are you using the feather blades?
Yes, I am. I'm using the feather blade. Thank you so much for that compliment, by the way. Yes, I'm using the feather blade and it's my favorite blade. I know, Randy, you sell them, don't you?
Yeah.
And you were selling out of them through COVID.
Yeah, hairbrain.pro.
Yeah. So basically everything is in its natural fall, as you can see. Look, everything is working in its natural fall. And I'm still using my guide. And if anybody wants to see now, look at the direction of the blade. Okay, so you have a diagonal. Now watch, just goes like so. I've moved my hand away from the blade a little so as I can get in there. And I'm just basically working down like that.
Nice.
Okay, now I follow that section around, just like we said. And we go back into our natural fall. Natural fall. Always go back to where you were going because it'll just keep you, it'll keep you right.
Eileen McEarl Patel is saying, hi Shay, how are you keeping? Great work. Need to rewatch this as I tuned in a wee bit too late.
Okay.
She sends a lot.
How are you doing, Eileen? Eileen's been a follower for a while, so it's great. She always adds nice comments and questions, and that's what it's about. It's
community.
It is community, and it's trying to share ideas. There's no right, there's no wrongs. It's more about, like, you know, people discussing and having forums about why do you use the blade, or why would you use it on this type of hair? You know, like, the blade is something that you're not going to use on everybody's hair, but when you want to use it on the right head of hair, wow, it really, really works.
Sweden is in the house.
Sweden Christine. Is in the house. The Swedes are in the house.
Yeah. Mary is asking, what inspired you to create this cut?
And it was wrap cutting technique, Mary, that I sort of created the wrap cutting technique for one of the Sebastian looks. And I think that could be Mary from the UK. If it is, say hi.
Jogin?
Yeah. Yep. So it's one of those things that I just sort of, I worked on it, and then I sort of looked at it on long hair and say, well, why can't I do it on short hair? Mm. So what we want to try and do is we've now sort of built that length, if you can see where we are, and we sort of built that sort of length where it sort of now works from shorter to longer with our asymmetric shape. Remember when we pulled the hair over, we took that weight away. Now what we need to do is to think of like also reducing the weight here so that we don't have too much bulk. So a reference point was the top of the ear where we cut the hair on the other side. So what we really need to do is look at now where we're working shorter. Let me just fix that line just a little.
You got the right Mary.
I got the right Mary. Hey, Mary. So let me just fix that line a little bit there.
So that's not easy to trim hair like that.
No. It takes a bit of work. So now what we want to try and do is go from this guide in our natural fall and elongate that stroke a little bit. So I just want you to sort of elongate the stroke. So what's that doing? It's just going to reduce that weight just a little bit more. So you don't have too much bulk there. Mm-hmm. Because, I mean, I love asymmetric shapes, but I don't like to have something that's unbalanced. It has to be sort of nice to the eye that it's balanced all around. So next section, and just, it's almost like that C curvature.
And because you work in the studio so often, options are everything for you, right?
Yes. And also, like, I love to be able to transform the hair. So what if this is going to be wavy? Or what if it's going to be something that's sort of like, you know, you want to be able to make it sort of stick out underneath and be a little bit more arty.
And clients love that, too.
And clients love to be able to transform their hair. So again, do not go horizontal with it. Follow the line. So the blade now stays here, about the middle of the ear, and just elongate that stroke. You'll see the hair and the weight come away. And then you can just pop it off.
Frog is asking how often you change the blade.
Every haircut, and sometimes I'll you know, do it between a haircut, depending on the hair that I'm working with.
Some textures,
yeah, they eat the blades up. So, mm-hmm. You have to be very aware of, you know, the client or, you know, the model or whoever you're dealing with and the hair texture. So again, I'm just keeping the diagonal on that blade. I'm just reducing a little bit of weight. So as I said, we still have a balance. We don't want to have it that it's too heavy on one side. I think that can look a little dated. So it's just reducing that weight a little bit more. Next section, bring it around. And remember, it's natural fall. So down.
I notice your sections have gotten just a little bigger from the from the other side.
Yeah.
But you're not in a hurry to get through it. You let the razor.
And because we have taken a lot of the weight away anyway from the wrap cutting, we can be a little bit thicker with the sections. Mm. So that's a little bit easier. So again, you can just go in and just start to take that weight out first. And that reduces that, so as it fits it in, you can see it's starting to fit in a little bit better. Now let's turn the doll head around. So we've worked right to the back of the ear. Now we want to blend everything in here. So again, just take it.
How did you know when you needed to change direction?
Well, I run out of hair. So it's really, I work from framing the face to the back of the ear. And now I'm left with almost a tail, like a corner tail. So now it's a case of connecting from here to here. So that's all you're really left with. It's almost like you've got diamonds, you know, or triangles.
Okay.
So now I've sort of, if I comb the hair down, hopefully we'll have run out of hair. So let's comb the hair down. So we've almost run out of hair there.
So at natural fall, any of the hair that's going to live on the side, you comb over to that side.
Yes.
And then you know that this last triangle is going to come over the back, so that's...
Exactly. Okay. So now we can just take this section away. You'll probably see things a little bit better now.
Frog is asking what lotion you have in the hair.
I have dark oil, and I have Potion 9 Light.
And you have a spray here that you used on that one, but what is the...
That's just water spray that I've been using. Yeah. And I use the mist. This is the mist that I use on the hair when I was blow drying that doll head for you guys. So this is the mist, the dark oil mist. So basically I put it into the hair when I'm blow drying it, so as you get a really nice smooth finish to the hair. Because again, these doll heads are, they're bleached so much that you really have to sort of be aware that, like, it's not like human hair, you know. It's just, it's very, very hard to sort of make it look beautiful, you know. So you need a liquid tool or something to help you out there a little bit.
Greg Clark saying, love the grip, where can I get them?
Love the grips. Oh, Greg. Basically, I get these in Salon Centric across the road. And I suppose they're supposed to be used for session work where, you know, you can use them.
We sell those at HB Pro.
Oh, there you go.
Hairbrain.pro.
So there you go, Craig. Greg, you just go on and you just buy them on Hairbrain Pro. So they're amazing if you're styling hair because they don't leave any marks in the hair. So they're fantastic. But also for when you're cutting hair, they're great because they keep the hair flat. If you sort of put lines or big grips in the hair, all of a sudden, as the hair is drying out, you get these really strange marks. So I would just go straight on to Hairbrained. You can get them there. Greg's a big Manchester United fan. He'll be very happy.
Cool.
So again, I'm just literally going through the hair, taking that weight out. Taking a little bit more weight on this side here. Yeah, and you're wanting it to fit in. So I'm just gently going through, and I want it to fit in. So I'm just gently blending and softening that. Blending, softening. Next section. Nearly there. So I'm going to guide us from here, take a small section so you see, and you can just basically go through the hair.
Greg said glory, glory.
Glory, glory. That's right.
Mary is asking about new products. She wants a spoiler. You have new products coming out?
We do, Mary.
But anything you can talk about? Knowing that your bosses are watching.
Yeah, my bosses are watching. So I think we do have a very good product for smoothening hair. So I can maybe say something like that. So I think that would be very interesting, Mary. So let me just keep going, just reducing that weight.
That's looking beautiful.
Yeah, thank you. But it's a really simple little haircut, but it's very effective. And as I said, I'd love for you guys to take it whatever way. You can take this to the max and you can have it, you know, super long. You know, you can have it whatever way you want. But for me, I'm just sort of, this is more about the actual haircut itself, and for me just to show you how it's created. But you can go as strong as you want.
And your elevation's pretty low here.
Yes, exactly.
Is that because it's already layered?
Exactly, because if I was to continually go out here, I think we would lose, really what we're trying to do is we're trying to create something that's really cool and asymmetric. So I feel that if I was to pull it out to the middle of the head, that's a great actually question, because I forgot to even say that you know, you've cut underneath already. So it's one of those things that you want to make sure that you are low on the elevation going up on the other side. So now I'm just
Pepe from Spain says hello.
Who?
Pepe? Or is it Mexico? Sorry, I'm not wearing my glasses. There's a flag there.
Yeah. Or it could be Pedro.
No, I can
it's
see
Pepe?
The
Pepe. Pepe, yeah. Oh, okay, cool. Hey, Pepe.
Definitely a Sebastian guy. There's a lot of black hearts after.
Oh, a lot of black hearts. Great.
And Sophie says, Sophia says, such a great pleasure to watch.
Oh, thank you so much, Sophia. So I'm just finished on the rough basic cut.
Pepe said, amazing haircut.
So let me just, thank you, Pepe. Let me just shake the doll head back just a little bit.
You don't do that to your clients.
No. Well, maybe they could put their head upside down.
Oh, that is so cool.
So you've got this really...
What a summer haircut.
Yeah, you've got this slightly asymmetric shape going on. It's soft. It could be worn just if we were to sort of think of something like we could put in some sort of natural sort of products like a Potion 9. You could have it sort of where, you know, the hair actually works really organic in its shape. And you could have little bits that stick out. And
that is so great.
And it just moves around the head. And then
lots of compliments coming in.
You know, you get this really cool little soft feminine shape. So you get like, you know, a wash and go. You know?
Mm-hmm. Greg is saying that would look really good on a gent as well.
Oh, it would look great on a guy. Yeah. Absolutely. It's got like a little bit of a Rolling Stones, you know, sort of like longer fringe and things like that. But maybe we should do this, is if I take the finished look, which I had to blow dry, and then we can bring them together. And you can see that we have...
the options, yeah.
So you get a different feel.
Finish, yeah.
Now,
you're getting kind of far apart for the...
There you go.
Love it. So cool.
So I'm just going to do the detailing on the straight look. Maybe we can leave...
Yeah, make sure you tell us what you put in this prior.
Yeah. So let's go to the straight look. So basically what I did was I blow dried the hair. And I reapplied dark oil, so because dark oil is always going to give you a really smooth, helping finish.
And it's so lightweight.
Yes.
I'm always amazed by it.
You can still have volume. You can still create volume. But the dark oil really, really helps to smoothen the cuticle out. And then I just used some of the mist. And again, this is from the dark oil family. And basically, you can apply it on dry hair the next day. And basically what it does is it's lighter for some people. They just want the next day hair. If it's a little frizzy, it can take away frizzy bits. It can also sort of give a bit more shine and takes away any of those bedhead looks if you want to brush their hair down.
So, if you rubbed around on the pillow a little bit, exactly. Sleeping, yeah.
So what I want to do is two things. I just want to go through it with my large blending shear. So
are you going to close up of that? You can just leave it right in front of your shirt there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So the teeth are quite big.
Yeah, and it's kind of curved.
And it's curved, exactly. So
does that give you a softer finish?
Exactly. So what it is I use this blade to filter the hair. So if I was to go in horizontally with a blade like that, and if I was to cut it, obviously it's going to leave a demarcation line. It's going to make hair come out. But if I want to just reduce a little bit of that weight, as you can see, there's a little bit of weight there. I like to go in at a diagonal, like I call this diagonal, like vertical diagonal, like go in like so, close, and then just take out the hair. Go in, close, and take out. And it's really just detailing where you've actually sort of put the line in. So I'm just
go slightly above the weight to do this.
Just exactly.
So you don't create more.
If you can actually look at where the top of the ear is, you're just going above the top of the ear, just where that weight is. Go in, close it, and down, in, and down, and that's gently going to take away a little bit of that bulk. Can you see it disappear a little?
Mm-hmm.
So you're just going to go in. And pull, go in, and pull. So the blending shears obviously can be used in so many different ways, I don't necessarily like to use it too much horizontally, but I do really like to use it when I'm sort of fitting in the hair. And sometimes I'll even take a section away like so, leave the top section above, and then when I go in, I go underneath. So I can just go in and gently go underneath. Yeah, cool. And then maybe let that hang over on top.
Oh, that looks so good.
Yeah, so you get that little disconnect.
So we have a couple of comments and a question. Yeah. Greg is just saying, fantastic, as I'd expect from you, Mr. Dempsey, flying the flag for, again, I can't tell if that's Italy.
Ireland.
Ireland in the, sorry. Awful. In the U.S., love. And Eileen said, I can't tell if she's asking you to do the haircut on her son, or she said, I'm doing a short haircut today, on my 20-year-old kind of mohawk.
Yeah.
I sent you a private message with a photo, could you, and then it cuts her message off and I can't get it to open up, so okay. I can't tell if she's asking you to
do the haircut. So she sent me a DM on my page,
yeah.
So I'll have a look at it, and I'm actually doing a haircut directly after this for a friend of mine at home, so I'll have a look and I'll get back to you. So as you can see, I'm just really, really just working around the head. So I want to show you now by taking this weight out, let me just move the doll head up.
Savas is a man, said, well done. Genius, my friend. Plus, I'm not a woman. Laugh out loud. That was my bad. I'm sorry. Oh, that looks so nice.
So now, by filtering and taking the time out, I hope you can see this.
Can.
So it's good. Now starting to fit into that undercut. And now, it almost melts in.
Louise asking if you sell those scissors.
Louise? No, I wish I would, but...
Louis? Yeah.
Yeah, no, I don't, but we've been
not
talking...
Yet.
Exactly. So that's another little bit of news that's hopefully going to happen. So you can see just going in, and now by just reducing that weight now, it starts to really fit in. So things become a little seamless. You don't know where it starts or where it ends, or, you know, you can actually start to see if I move the head throughout. Everything starts to just be a little bit more seamless and it fits into the head, which I love. I don't necessarily love like big, bold, solid lines. I like things that can transform. And then the final little piece is that everybody loves an accent. Like an accent can be anywhere. So it can be the fringe, can be the accent.
Do you mind sharing the brand of those scissors?
Of course,
a couple of people
Mizutani's.
Are asking. Mizutani. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So, I use Mizutani blades as well. Mm-hmm. So, the accent, as I said, can be the fringe. It can be the line. But I want to just try and do something here. Just
okay.
To create something. Just a little quirk.
Do you need a mirror? We could move that way and you could use the mirror. Yeah.
Great, because I can't really see what I'm doing here.
I can even stand out of your way.
There we go. So now I can see exactly, I've reduced that way through here. So if I look at it here, I want to just try and create something like a little disconnection. So usually what I'll do is, again, like as I do with the fringes, I always take small amounts.
I'm just going to show them what you're taking there.
Yeah, I'm just going to take a little tiny circle by using my comb. A little circle, like tiny. Let's go a little bit more. So there. So that would be right on that crown, or that accent is on the accent of the head. So you can do it lots of different ways. You can take it, you could twist it a little bit like this, if you want. And you can go in and you can go gently, like so. So you're doing shorter bits to hold the other bits up. And just go gently and see how it goes. This is where the artistic part of you as a hairdresser comes out. Because I don't know how this is going to work out. Like, to be honest, this could be a disaster. But I mean, that's the nice bit about it.
Don't make me laugh. I'm trying to hold this thing.
There it goes. So a little bit there. So, okay, so it hasn't jumped enough for me. So now I'm going to go in and take another little piece. And by twisting it, hopefully those other little bits are going to show me where I am. So I'm going to go again. Just use my scissor. Going shorter to longer. So that I have a little bit of hair to sort of just need a little accent.
Greg, this is a iPhone.
Greg's asking.
Yeah, what kind of camera
is this? It's crazy that an iPhone can do this.
Yeah.
So now I'm following my little piece, and I'm probably, this will be my last section.
So your circle just getting bigger and bigger?
Bigger and bigger. So here you can see the pieces that I've already cut. Now I'm just going to go in and squeeze that blade right through.
And if you had to estimate, like, are you changing any kind of lengths or anything as you go through those three circles?
No, I'm just basically, you know, I'm really
staying around there.
I'm eyeing this up. Okay. This is a total artistic sort of let yourself go and just pick it up. And then sometimes, like, you'll want to go in on that piece that's still in my hand. Is that maybe you want to go in and just give it a little bit more?
And do you want to do this right on if you have a whirl back there, do you want to do it right on the whirl?
Yeah, okay. You want to do it on the whirl.
Yeah. I guess it's a cowlick.
Cowlick, whirl.
Oh, that's cool.
So you don't want it to be something that's sort of standing up like crazy. Because what will happen is then it sort of looks a little bit 80s. You know what I mean? We don't want to do that. But what you want to try and do is create something that if I put some product in, and I'm going to put a little bit of something like, say I use a little bit of craft clay. The craft clay will give me a little bit of hold. So let's just get a bit of craft clay in here.
Savas said, I want to meet you in person with Andrew Dunn. You guys are, take a class with you both, you're Irish masters.
Yeah. Thank you so much. So a little bit of craft clay, like we're not going too crazy. And let's just see, we just gently just move it around a little bit.
That is nice, Shay. You really should think about doing this seriously. Looks like you did her makeup too. All of a sudden I'm like,
no. Yeah, she's come alive. Yep. She's woken up a little.
Denmark is saying thank you.
Anthony
says, love your technique. Fortunata says, beautiful. Kelly is complimenting your lighting in your salon.
Oh, thank you.
It's nice, and it's nice and empty in here right now because of this virus.
That's another.
Sorry for that, Shay.
That's another. Yeah. Well, we can just
send your donations to.
Oh, mamma mia!
Yeah.
I don't know whether to laugh or cry when people talk about it, but anyway, we just got to keep going.
Yeah.
There's still people in Brazil that haven't even reopened yet. My heart goes out to them in Brazil. But
got a hello from Moscow.
Oh, hi, Moscow.
And hey from Sweden. The Swedes say, hey, so sweet.
Yeah, good, good, good. Okay, so.
That is nice.
It's just a little shape. I mean, it's cute.
Mm-hmm.
It's got that disconnection to it. You know, it's got the disconnect here, it's got that little bit of asymmetry, it's a little nice and chewy, it's, you know, it can be worn in so many different ways. As I said, if we bring the two girls together, you've got that more natural look where it's
the beach hair.
Like beachy hair, yep. You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, it's got the swish.
Mm-hmm.
But then again, if you wanted to blow dry it, and you wanted to put a little bit more texture in there, and the fact that we've created a little accent, it gives it a little bit more of an edge to it.
Alyssa's saying she wished she saw it from the beginning. The good news, Alyssa, is that you can, as soon as we close this live, you'll be able to go to our page, Hairbrain, look for the video section, and you'll be able to replay the whole thing.
Okay, so I hope you enjoyed it. As I said, the technique is there. You can watch it again, small sections. I go through everything. And enjoy it. And if you do the haircut,
where can we follow you?
Yeah, or follow me on Instagram, ShadeMC1. DM me with the pics. I'd love to see them, and I'll pass them on to Hairbrain and Sebastian. Thanks so much.